People. Que pasa, sapa, say what they do. Now, the first thing that is popping in the news and entertainment is that we see that outspoken selector, we are speaking about Futa Hype, is in ICE custody. And people, when we talk about ICE custody, we are speaking about immigration. We are talking about Border Patrol in the United States of America. And he is said to be in Chrome. And when we speak about Chrome, we are speaking about in Miami. We are speaking about, I think it's in Southwest Miami, somewhere down there. And people, if you know anything about Chrome, if you live in America, that is a place. If you are in America illegal, that is the place that everybody is scared of. Nobody wants to go there because they know, so basically it is a one-way ticket back home because you kind of violated some sort of U.S. immigration policy. Sometimes, in most cases. So based on information, it is said that Futa Hype went to the Jamrock cruise. And he has been missing since he went there and he performed as one of the selectors. We are speaking about a cruise that lovers of reggae and dancehall music attend. So anyways, it is said that he has been missing from then. And people understand with Futa Hype, he is very active on social media, Instagram. He is always going live speaking about all sorts of trending topic, rete, lele, blah, blah, bling. Some people did not see him on social media, so therefore people was kind of asking, where is Futa Hype? Why is Futa Hype missing? Because he knows that him love to talk a lot. So anyway, it is confirmed, and people, this is the documentation, this is the proof right here. He is in the custody of ICE, and we are speaking about in Chrome. Now, when we think about the situation, because the truth and the fact is that nobody really knows exactly why he is there and why ICE basically put him in custody. However, we can kind of analyze certain situation. First thing first, is Futa Hype a green card holder? Nobody knows. He never really said. None of his friends, I am speaking about Tony Mataran, nobody really spoke about his status. We are speaking about his legal status. Is he a resident of America? Is he a temporary green card holder? Because people, the truth and the fact is that if you're a green card holder or you're a temporary green card holder, you can basically end up in an ICE custody because of the fact that you're not a US citizen. And I can almost guarantee or validate or verify with 100% surety that Futa Hype is not a US citizen, point blank and period. The next thing is that, is Futa Hype on a work permit? Because people, the truth and the fact is that if you get a work permit, it does not say that you can live in America. You are not a temporary resident or you are not a green card holder. You are not a legal resident. So therefore, you're supposed to go and do your work and go back to your yard. It only gives you access. In other words, it prevents you to have to go to the embassy every time that you are going on a gig. And I am speaking about as a selector or as a dancehall artist that are touring on a regular basis. That means that what this work permit allows you to do is do your work freely without any sort of hindrance. That means you don't have to go back and forth to the immigration every time that you need to tour or every week that you need to go to America. Rete, lele, blah, blah, bling. However, with this work permit, you cannot just act on ASS like we see Futa Hype has been acting up on social media. And people, it is okay to be outspoken. It is okay to give your opinion. It is okay to be vocal on certain topics. But you have to understand that sometimes when you speak, and sometimes when you have your hand in the lion's mouth, and sometimes when you're there Uncle Sam place, you have to be very cautious because you can violate that green card or work permit or temporary green card rate and lele very easily. Now, like me say, I see that Futa Hype has been going back and forth from America to Jamaica, all over the place, London, to some Caribbean country. So I can come to the logical conclusion that he is there legally, or he was there legally. Now, people, like me say, I don't know his legal status in America. I don't know if there is a decision or there was a pending decision being made by Immigration, Border Patrol, and ICE, Ratey and Lely. And they basically sent that decision to an address that is old, and Footer Hype did not get it. However, as it pertains to the immigration policy, if you move from one address to a new address, you are supposed to notify them. It is your obligation. It is not theirs to try and chase you down and find you. So therefore, if they make a decision and they sent you a letter or a notification and you did not get the notification and you did not respond in time, you can also violate your residency, your green card, or your temporary status, or your work permit. Point blank and period. Is that a case? I don't know. I am just saying it is a possible scenario. Now, the next thing that we have to take into consideration is the fact that we see that Footer Hype has been very vocal on social media as it pertains to the fishy community. We are talking about the Shibada, we are talking about the Quiet Perry them, we are speaking about the people them of the alphabet type. Now, people, we have to understand as it pertains to America, they are God, they are some powerful people. So therefore, anytime you lash out or you BASH them, you are going to have problems point blank and period. They are very powerful. They are one of the most powerful, if not the most powerful group in America, because basically everybody, are most people that are involved in the entertainment industry, we talk about music, they are mostly FISHY people, point blank and period. So therefore, when Footer Hype goes on social media on a daily basis back and forth every day for months, for years, Ratey and Lely, he is only doing himself a disservice. He has to understand you are in Uncle Sam's place, and Uncle Sam's place is full of fishes. We are speaking about a big old aquarium. We are speaking about the Atlantic Ocean. We are talking about the Caribbean Sea. It's full of fish. So when him come on social media and abash the people, he is only inciting some sort of stuff where them call HATE crime. That means that you are inciting persons to basically hate upon some other people because of their sexual orientation. People, that is a strike, point blank and period. And people, don't get it twisted, don't get it misconstrued. I am not saying or claiming that that is the reason that he's in the custody of ICE. I am just saying it is a possible scenario. Now, the next possible scenario, what is his relation with his baby mother? We are talking about his baby mother that lives in the United States, because we know same have one picnic with Aishana. Is he paying child support on a regular basis? Is he conforming to the courts to make sure that he is taking care of any child that he has that is under 18 years old? People, I don't know. I am not saying that he is not paying. I am not saying that he is. I am just saying that that is a possible scenario. Because according to US rules and laws and regulation, if you are not paying child support, you can lose all access to driver's license and also your residency. Also, if you are a green card holder or you're on a work permit, people, that is a cause for kind of lose it, point blank and period. And people, let me put it out there, this is my disclaimer. I am not saying that that is what happened. I am just saying that that is also a possible scenario. Now, the next thing is that we know that most of the persons that watch Footer Hype on social media, at least 75% of them don't like him. So there's also a next possible scenario, is that people or persons are filing all sorts of false claims and allegations against Footer Hype, saying that he is doing this or he is doing that or he is threatening them, Ratey, Lele, blue, blah, bling. That is also cause for ICE or Immigration take him into custody, because you would be threatening persons that live in America. We are talking about permanent residents and even worse, citizens of United States. People, it is very problematic. You have to understand your status. You have to understand your place when you are living in America, especially if you are not a citizen of America. So people, me basically lay out at least four options or four scenarios, likely scenarios, based on foot of hype situation that might have caused him to be in the custody. And people, like me said, don't get it twisted, don't get it misconstrued. It might be something else that nobody knows. Because the truth and the fact is that I don't know what type of involvement foot of hype is in as it pertains to America, legal or illegal. I am not saying that he is, me just as I never know. We cannot swear for any and anybody anytime, point blank and period. So anyways, my advice to foot of hype is this: if you can, you need to get a good immigration lawyer, because it is complex. We are speaking about the immigration rules and laws and regulations are very complex. So therefore, you need competent people. You need people that are versed in the immigration law. So basically, you cannot take a case upon your head and talk about you want to represent yourself. No, because these people, I am talking about the prosecution. I am speaking about the lawyers for this immigration court or immigration facility. They will twist you up into a pretzel. So people, at the end of the day, and the moral of the story is this: nobody really knows what is the situation as it pertains to foot of hype himself. And even he might not know, even he might be confused of why he was taken into custody. But like me say, maybe this is just a routine checkup to make sure that he is okay, make sure that all the allegations that they are hearing is false. So therefore, they might just be doing a little checkup and then they are going to let him out. And then he would know. Him should learn from his experience, him have to basically behave him raw self. And this would also be a warning to foot of hype for basically take heed, because whenever you hand in at the lion mouth, you have to be careful how you take it out, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.